Welcome to the May session of Assert Tech Day. Thank you very much for coming. I'm sure most of you are excited about today's event. At the very outset, I would like to thank Canon India for their sponsorship last month. Can we give a round of applause to Canon? And we are pleased to announce that K7 Computing has also become a gold sponsor. A big round of applause for them as well. A special thank you to Mr. Rahul Jhaveri of Apex Enterprises Canon. Round of applause for him. Because thanks to him, he was instrumental in getting Canon into the Assert fold. And they were really responsible at a very, very short notice to sponsor our last annual day event which we had in Juhu. Let me also tell you, currently our gold sponsors with the Assert are Asus, Netgear, SIFI, K7 Computing. And I'm also very, very pleased and happy to announce that Microsoft has become a platinum sponsor. And round of applause for that, guys. Come on. That's a big achievement for Assert. They took a lot of time, but I think they soon realized the benefits of tying up with Assert. And we are glad that they are there. And also, Intel has also promised to sponsor the next month's event. So, also, since they are not there, let's give a round of applause. I'm sure they'll hear it in Bangalore. So we have some exciting, I'll just let you know the agenda for today. So obviously we have K7 Computing, who are going to first start with their topic about introducing their products and introducing K7 to most of us who don't know much about K7. Secondly, we have Canon, who will also once again demonstrate the products and explain to them the features of growing up with Canon. We have another very interesting sort of a small topic which is covered by one of our own partners. Very, very interesting. I will not let you know about it. Let himself say when the time comes. How collaboration, thanks to Assert, thanks to their own efforts, they could collaborate and come up with a very, very unique sort of solution which they are offering to the market. And then we have Mr. Rajesh Dhawan, who is a CA, who will join us to discuss this burning issue which you all know about is LBT and VAT. So he'll be joining us at 6 o'clock to take that event. So without further ado, let me start today's first sponsor for today, K7 Computing. Let me introduce them to you first. K7 Computing offers world-class enterprise security products for your customers to increase endpoint productivity and increase convenience to manage endpoint, all with the lowest resource utilization. That's very important. While maximizing partner business profits. From K7, we have the Assistant Vice President, Mr. S.S. Kumar, who handles consumer K7 consumer products, heading enterprise business for K7. So let's give a round of applause to Mr. S.S. Kumar and welcome him on stage.
Good evening, gentlemen. Before I start, I would like to welcome our premium partner, Arihant, and I would like him to speak a few words.
Hello, good afternoon friends. We have tied up with K7 and it's a very good product, so we will need your support. We are distributor for VestZone. Thank you.
Thank you, Sulaji. During my presentation about next 40 minutes, I would take you through a couple of things like what is the K7 Computing as a company is about, all about, and what are the products that we offer. And among the, there is a lot of competition in the market already, it's already saturated. Why system integrators and solution providers like you should look into this product, and what is the business benefit that you get out of doing this business? So these are the few points we will cover. Let me get into the presentation myself. K7 Computing as a company, we are on the 20th or officially on the 22nd year of operation in India. The journey began about in 1989. I'll just take you through a small video. My presentation would be with a few documents, with a few videos to make it more interactive. Can we have the sound song?
T1 saw the rise of a determined young man from the city of Madras. Alone he stood and believed in his courage to stand against online terror. He fought all odds to develop the first Indian antivirus, VX2000. a weapon that changed the way we fought the enemy legions of viruses and hackers. He then engineered a technology that was taken and sold by the category leader, Cybermedia, now a part of McAfee. His ambition was grand enough to take him to Japan, where superior technology devised by him and his team began a revolution in the antivirus category. Many awards and honors came his way. Now, with a vision to give the world the best product ever made in India, he leads K7. Presenting Mr. Kesavardhanan, the general with a smile.
It's always been my dream and ambition for the tag made in India relevant across the world. Today, however, it does hold tremendous value, especially in software services industry. But the world still needs to take notice of a software product from India. I have no doubt that Kesavardhanan Computing can be the undisputed leader. To do that, we need right partners who are constantly challenging the market and seeking newer opportunities. I invite you to join us in transforming Kesavardhanan Computing into India's leading software product company.
That was Mr. Kesavan, who is the founder and CEO of Kesavan Computing. So the name itself, K7, it is from the Indian name Kesavardhanan. It's very common in this industry that Steve Norton and Kaspersky, Eugene Kaspersky, or McAfee is McAfee name. And so Kesavardhanan is Kesavan. So that's how the name is K7. There are a few awards, and one of the recent awards which been won by K7 is for the award of innovation. And this award has been got by K7 for the past two consecutive years from the governor of Tamil Nadu. I'll take you through the little highlights of this company as of now. We are, right now as of date, we protect about 12 million endpoints. And we have a footprint in almost all the countries. If you talk about, maybe the penetration levels would vary in if you talk about Iran or America or Africa, the penetration levels would differ, but we are present in almost all the countries now. One of the highlighting points is that we are one of the fastest growing brand in Japan, and we have won the ProReiki award for the last 6 consecutive years. And as of now, the latest statistics says that we have about 24% market share in Japan, Japanese market. Why we are very proud about this? Because this is an... Thank you, guys. Why we are very proud of this product is, you know, this point here, because I want to put a question here, like, if you have an opportunity to buy a Chinese product or a Japanese product, which one would you prefer? You prefer a Japanese? It's quite common with everyone, because the Japanese product, it stands with the quality. For example, Toyota or Sharp or Sony, for any of these products. So it was not easy for us to cut across the competition in Japan, because it was a tough market for the quality. And the first year was really tough. Second year we have beaten Trend Micro, and the third year we beat Symantec there in Japan. So we hold about 24% market share and almost about 10 million customers in Japan. We have, to further going down, we have a state-of-the-art R&D facility right in India, that's in Tamil Nadu. We have the complete thing, and the entire the world, all the products have been supported from Chennai. We are featured as one among the top 3 AV in Indian consumer market. I represent the enterprise business. Many of you would have heard about K7 in the name of consumer market, but we have grown into the enterprise market, and this year, the last year, but 9 months old, we launched in India, in Indian market, this enterprise business. Recent, there was an acquisition from a company from US, that is by name Central Command. K7 acquired a company called Central Command in US, by which we have about 4,000 plus customers in US. So further the success from Japanese market, we have acquired about this company, and I would like to just play one more video from the person who was there in the industry for about 23 years, who decided to join or merge with K7 Computing for the future growth. I would like to have just play this video for that, you know, to see.
Hello everyone, my name is Keith Peter. I was President and CEO of Central Command in the United States. Central Command was one of the oldest antivirus software companies in the world. I founded and operated the company profitably for over 23 years. It was recently acquired by K7. I now lead the North American operations of K7. Many people have asked me why I chose K7 when I had many other opportunities. To me, it was an easy decision. I have known the management team of K7 for quite some time, and I deeply believe that K7 is on the verge of becoming a world-leading data security company. K7 is positioned to take over the market. This is an exciting time for everyone at K7. Our products are perfectly positioned to compete against all of our competitors successfully. Our products are great. In fact, our products are awesome. Every one of you today watching me has a tremendous opportunity to be part of a company that provides award-winning solutions for its customers that actually benefit them. Our products solve customer problems. Our products protect people from criminals. Do you know how important that is? When you sell K7 to a customer, you are personally helping them. They just don't know that. Isn't that a great feeling? It sure is. Our competitors do not provide the protection we do. Our competitors do not support their customers as good as we do. Our competitors don't care about their customers like we do. It's important for you selling K7 to believe that when you don't sell K7 to a customer, it's actually very bad for them. They are going to continue to suffer until they buy K7. Not for a moment, just think about all the people who are suffering without K7. You have a tremendous opportunity to earn a terrific income selling K7 to everyone. No matter what they are using today, whether it is Kaspersky, QuickKeel, AVG, ESET, McAfee, or Symantec, they are suffering because they are not using K7. It's up to you and it's your job to change that. Since February 1st, we have been selling K7 in the United States, and it's been going great. For the first 18 months, we are focusing on selling K7 Enterprise Security. We here in the U.S. are selling directly to small and medium businesses, large enterprises, and the government and education sectors. I can tell you with much confidence that K7 Enterprise Security is the perfect fit for these markets. It is exceptionally well received. We have clients ranging from 5 endpoints to over 15,000. Each of them have told us that K7 is significantly better than what they've been using, and these customers have been using all other products from all other competitors. You have to remember that the U.S. market is extremely competitive and saturated with products from all vendors. So the fact that the customers are telling us that K7 is protecting them better than what they have been using is easier to manage and gives them peace of mind is significant. This means that our customers are feeling better protected. I can tell you this, our customers love K7. I have personally spoken with many of them, and they tell me all kinds of great things that K7 is doing for them. They love the malware protection. They love the web filtering. They love the application control and many more features of K7. We hear it every day from our new customers. Do you know what this means? It means that our product managers and our development team are building solutions that are in demand today. We are ahead of our competitors in delivering what the customers actually want to buy. And that's awesome for K7 and you as salespeople. It's your job to help our future customers understand how great our software is. When a customer does not buy K7, it's bad for them. They just don't know how bad it is. You are working for a great company selling great products that benefit our customers. In my 23 years in the antivirus business, I have never been more excited about a company and its products. I am thrilled to be part of K7. This is going to be a great year for us. We are going to help a lot of people get protected by K7. I hope that I get a chance to meet each of you. Also, I hope for you that this year, you meet and exceed all of your goals. So bye for now from the U.S. Office of K7.
Now, for every any of your customer, it so happens, you know, when the moment they install an antivirus into their laptop or a desktop, everybody voiced one thing. What is the best, the main complaint generally they make when they install an antivirus into a laptop? Speed. Which means, the moment any IT administrator, when you talk to your technical guys, you would be able to understand it. They complained about that. But the moment the antivirus has been installed into a huge network, the machine gets slowed down. Here is a solution for that. For the past 2 years, we have been ranked as number one in terms of performance. I'll just take you through international data. The report which I'm showing to you, it is already available on the website. This is not a report which has been prepared by us. In any antivirus solution when you sell to a customer, you would see this particular logo there, AV comparators. They compare all the 32 brands around the world. I'll just take you to the relevant page because it's a huge report. Yeah. Something wrong with the configuration of the screen. Yeah. You would see on the left-hand side, almost all the antivirus been listed there, including McAfee, Kaspersky, Microsoft, Symantec, Tenmicro, and all of them. And what this comparative agency which they did is, they tested the product in terms of when they do a file copying, when they are archiving, unarchiving, encoding, installing an application for the first time, the second time, opening a Word file for the first time, the second time. And they tested the performance of that. And they summarized the report like this. Without an antivirus in a machine, when they did all these testing, the PC mark score was set as 2024. And after installing K7, the performance dropped to 2020. But you could see the rest of the competition out here, right from Trendmicro, McAfee, Microsoft, Kaspersky, or any of them. So K7 is in this position, in its number one position, the last 2 years, consecutive 2 years, and unbeaten. Is it interesting for you that it doesn't prove that it doesn't slow down the machines of your customers? And if you are able to provide an antivirus solution to a customer and if this laptop doesn't slow down, that's going to be one of the good solutions that you can provide to the customer. Because none of these people, they buy a laptop not for running an antivirus, but they buy a laptop only for running their business applications, the ERP or the Outlook or whatever it is. So here, we don't delay. For an example, I'll take my small little laptop, it runs an antivirus server. One of the biggest differentiator here is, unlike any competition, to run an antivirus server, I do not ask for a server. I do not ask you for a Windows 2000 server. My antivirus server even can run on an Atom processor or Windows XP. That is the only thing that we require to run an antivirus server. I don't need a server class machine or not the server. Now look at it here. So in this machine, I run both server and a client. And you would see the memory utilization that has been there here. It's about 1188 kilobytes. It's as slow as this. When you go back, please do check your machine and see how much memory here and the rest of the competition would be occupying. You would see at least not less than 25,000 kilobytes there being used. Any questions? Yeah. Why I pulled this report is because to show you that this is whatever I'm talking is not now out of the exaggerated. This is all reality what I'm talking about. Few of my friends they also asked me if you say that your machine is you don't occupy the memory, but is it effective? Does it capture the virus? I have an answer for you on that question also. For the time being, I'm just quitting this presentation. For the people who are at the back side, probably this may not be very visible, so I'll just try to make it a little more bigger. This is a report, again from, I'm sure everybody, every system solution provider, you sell a UTM box here, maybe a firewall or any of this. And every firewall, UTM box, they use a common database called Comptons. This is a report from the Comptons. It says, K7 computing identifying a virus, the virus, in the zero hour. Whereas, you would see the competition out here. Most of them, there is not even a detection during the during this period, analysis period. This, I'm just trying to air this to prove a point that it captures the virus at the 0 hour. What does a 0 hour mean is here. People who can read it is, a 0 hour detection indicates detection and blockage of the malware within the earliest moments of its outbreak. So we are very less resource hungry, the product, and it also captures viruses 100% in the 0 hour. Those 2 points, because why I'm addressing these points, because I was talking to a few of the people around here before the presentation, and I asked a few questions. In case, if you have to support the K7 product, what are things you expect? Then he said, if there is quality, and if it captures the virus, we would, and if there are support, proper support, we would support your brand. So I already answered 2 points, the only support is left now. It's not that I'm standing in front of you for the first time. We are not launching the product, because we are there in the industry for the last 9 months in the enterprise space. And these are the few of the clients that I can mention out here. Out of this, Padmasri DY, Dr. DY Patil College of Architecture in Mumbai itself, who are our customer, Chandigarh University or Tijon Group of Institutions. These are the lot of educational institutions being, who are our customers as of today. Talk about any of the hospital vertical, talk about any of the vertical, we have a customer. Even a Konkan Mercantile Bank from Mumbai is our customer. Akshay Patra from Rajasthan is our customer. These are the few other customers on IT-ITS, the media, and from manufacturing. They manufacture the steering for Hyundai cars. And Tratec is from, and control and switch gear is from Delhi. So the nutshell is that we are not standing in front of you as a new company or anything. We have been there in this, we have been tested the market, and the customers have accepted the product. Now it's only that, you know, we want your support. When I'm asking for the support, it's not that I'm asking your support only for the, I mean, only for the antivirus portion. Because K7 as a company has got a larger vision. We'll be a holistic company, a security company in the next few years. Today what we have is, we have developed our own. It's not that we outsource some the core engine from somebody else. We have developed, Mr. K7 as the core architect of the product. He has developed the core engine. The next product we'll be adding up. These are the consumer products already there in the market. Right now we are talking about K7 Enterprise, the first one. We will be very soon launching the SecureWare. We will be coming up with the online backup on the data access and the Microsoft Office on demand. This will be the rest of the product will be coming under field. And this terminology is very common these days, that we bring your own device. So we will be a part of this here also. And this is going to be a game-changing technology from K7 into the enterprise market, that is going to be the secure virtual endpoint. This is, you know, probably everybody would be selling the solutions from VMware and Citrix to virtualize the applications or the servers, things like that. But here it's going to be a little different. We will be coming up with a new technology, which we are not going to compete with VMware or Citrix, but we would be coming up with a secured virtual, a little makeshift arrangement for VDI concept. But today, why VMware or Citrix, the VDI is not being successful in the market is just because it is very costly or very resource hungry. We are going to replace that particular thing with a secure virtual endpoint. And all these things, we are trying to bring it on our cloud. So dear partners, like, when you get your engineers trained on K7 technology, and when you invest your time and money on our company, it's not that, you know, we are going to be a growing company in the enterprise security space. So once you sell our enterprise starter pack, the product, we would be adding one by one onto that particular license. So the first launch today is only to create a relationship between you and your customers, and you would be adding a products one by one on top of. So finally, the KSMN as a company, the brand promise what we make is the data, the applications will be always secure and will be delivered anytime, if anywhere and on any device. This is the KSMN brand promise that we are going to give it to the partners here. We formed a project Synergy and it was launched on 22 February 2013. We took this, like what I'm talking to you today here, we went to different cities of country, Jaipur, Chennai, Bangalore, Chandigarh, Hyderabad and Cochin, and now here in Mumbai. What we are trying to do here is a kind of creating a synergy between the OEM, the premium partner and you as a brand ambassador. We are trying to create a journey of success with high profit. With this model, we are trying to reach Pan India in this 1 year. In the next 12 months, we would be reaching out these all these places. For West, we have the premium partner as Arihant Info Solutions. And under Arihant Info Solutions, we will be having the value-added resellers in all the Western region, which would be talking to all of the brand ambassadors like you. This is the product which I'm talking about here. This is the KSMN Enterprise Protection, Endpoint Protection Suite, which has been packed as an expandable license, which is packed in 51 user license. Because so far you would have heard about 3 user license, 1 user license, but here we are talking about 51 user license. It's been packed and kept. Because why we are coming up with this model is because later we understood that the customer has to see the product, they have to test the product, and then they go for the product. Therefore, we have come with a starter pack. Once the starter pack is there, it's been sold to a customer, and once, in case if they have about 150 or 2000 endpoints, they can add the balance to the existing like startup bank. And therefore, this is going to be an expandable license. Talking about the little bit of the product, this product is nothing different from the others. It has got all the features, the combination, what they talk about, or maybe a little more. What we have added here is a convenience to the IT support, the IT admin, to migrate into this product. Because for example, I say the biggest pain point is that I'm okay with Symantec, now why should I move into this? And because the biggest pain point here they see is the migration from 2000 computers into a new product. But here we have made it simplified. My product, installation of a server, it takes about 5 minutes, and the endpoint takes about 3 seconds. It doesn't take more than that. And once you push the client from the server, the package goes into the endpoint, it uninstalls the existing antivirus, this will get automatically installed and report back to the server. So the IT admin's job is made very easy for migration. So we have solved one of the biggest challenges for all the system integrators, that migrating from an existing product into the KSMN endpoint protection has made it very, very easy. We have few good features which we called as application control. Maybe the other competition also has application control, but our application control is much more user friendly. For example, you could restrict an application from launching, or you could restrict an application from executing itself, or you can allow an application but restrict its internet access. For example, like, you know, maybe few companies do not have a license for Adobe, but they want to use the Adobe for a week's time. They can download the particular application, just take an example. They can download the application, they can still use it, but they can cut the internet access so that it doesn't go to the internet for taking updates. Or this can be put another way also. For example, it's a large company, one of your companies has got an Active Directory services and it has got multiple groups. As the CEO passes on the way and he says that, I saw somebody playing a car game, and he reports to the IT admin and he goes off, walks off. The IT admin later smacks his head saying that, guys, who was playing it? How do I know? How do I go and ask my CEO that who was playing? Then he'll ask me, what the hell you're doing there? So all you have to do is, yes, get into the product, type the application name, game.exe. It will scan the entire network and report saying that this is the computer which has been using in the room. From the central console, he has only to do is right-click, block that application, so that it doesn't launch the next time. So I'm just giving only one example of it. This can be used even for that. Another web protection, if we are talking about how do we differ from the others, is I will take a case study here. There is a company which it's a retail outlet of Louisville. They have about 60 outlets in Tamil Nadu. And the biggest complaint of that particular CEO was, you know, every showroom they had to connect to the central server to do the billing. And what happened was, these the people who are the showroom people, they were using, exploiting their computer and the bandwidth for playing games or visiting websites, and they were not attending to the people who are walking in. So every system integrators, everybody suggested, what is the solution for that? Like, you know, what would you would suggest to the user if this is the problem? They have, I'm putting a case study here. There are 60 showrooms. The showrooms has to connect to the central server to connect to the billing. And they want to prevent the people using unwanted websites. They want to prevent applications using. So what solution do you generally suggest? Yeah. So generally what everybody will suggest is, okay, go ahead for a UTM. And today in the country, the minimum UTM would cost you not less than 30,000 rupees. And if they have to put it for 60 showrooms, it's going to be a lot of money, about 18 lakhs rupees he has to spend. But this case came to us, and what we did was, we installed our product, and the whole thing was completed with about 1,000 rupees per showroom. We got premium. Because he's, instead of spending 30,000 rupees, he paid only 1,000 rupees. So my partner paid it. What we did was, in the web protection, what we have, there are multiple features, like, you know, you have whitelist, blacklist. Apart from that, what we have is block all. And using the policy, what we did is, you will visit only louisvillip.com, nothing beyond. And we tied up all the applications. And therefore, the computer is almost locked up. And we have a USB vaccination. It's nothing like, you know, it's just similar to vaccinating your child against polio. It's nothing like that. It's something similar to that. For example, many of these design houses have got large files, huge files, which cannot be transmitted through an email. So what they generally do is, they go to the IT admin and ask, okay, before I do anything, give me the USB access for the time being now. I want to copy a file and take it to a customer place. And generally what happens is, IT admin forgets to revoke the policy and the USB port remains open. But here what you can do is, you can vaccinate that USB drive and leave it. The USB drive can go from your network to the customer place, even if it's virus infected, but it can still come back. The USB drive will be protected. It will not bring back the virus again back. So we call it as a USB vaccination. Apart from that, you have the device control. You can control the devices really properly. What I would suggest is, very soon my team here would be calling in for a technical training session. I would really request and urge to send your technical engineers for that training. The training will not only benefit your engineers to service K7 as an antivirus. We would train them on the latest tools also we would use, so that you can use the training for the other purpose also. It's not only to service the K7 clients. I would request, so we would send you an invite for all the, whenever the training happens, please do send your technical engineers. With this product, now what we are, how we are redefining is, we are trying to, this simple, I'm sure we'll be able to understand this, we are trying to give freedom to the reseller, because you are not the business owners of your business, and I do not know whether you want to get controlled by the OEMs to what price you should sell the product. So here we are trying to untie that, and we are giving you the freedom to fix the price, remove the dependence on the pricing from K7, and when the competition is talking to your customer for at what price, because there is no case locking that we are trying to bring it up here. And in front of your customer, you decide what margin you want, and you close the deal. When you sell K7, the starter pack, which is to the end customer now, when you buy it and sell it, you get about four benefits. One is, you get about 200% profit. Is it interesting for you guys? You make about, because today's industry that, the margin is diminishing, but here we are with a solution that, you get about 200%, 100%, you can hold me responsible for this, you would make about 200% profit. When you sell this 51 user license, and when the customer feels that, okay, this is a good product, because it's serving my purpose, and he wants to add more license, because when we sell and the starter pack gets registered with the customer, we know who is the reseller who has sold it, who is the system who has sold it. So whenever there is an additional license which comes to the requirement, it's all, it's only a paper license moving. You have to place an order, the additional 150 or maybe 2000 license will add on to the same license. And top of it, as I said, we are not going to be staying only with the endpoint. We will be going ahead with the other products like DLP or the on-off backup and all those things. All those things will get to the same console, to the same license will get tied up. So once you sell this starter pack to an end customer, whenever the new features are getting launched, without any other efforts, you would get the same business. And the more important that we do not have an online renewal mechanism. So all renewals will be happening through the same channel which has been sold to the customer. We don't take an online renewal automatically. So these are the four benefits. When you take a little effort, because you are getting about 200%, you take a little more effort to sell the product and you get about four benefits back. Here there is a little mathematics which I have brought up. I would like all of your attention here. There are starter kits which I was talking about, the starter packs. Each starter pack which costs about 7,425 rupees for a 51 user license. When you buy 3 starter packs, you invest into this business about 22,000 and odd rupees. And I've considered about 50% margin here, which you make the revenue out here. That means your margin is 11,000 rupees from this. Today our premium partner is launching a scheme that for this association that about 100% offer. Then when you buy about 3 starter packs, you get about 3 starter packs free. And from that 3 starter packs when you sell, you get about 33,000 rupees again. So the total gain from 3 starter packs when you buy, when you invest about 22,000 rupees into this business, you make about 44,000 rupees, which makes about 200%. Is it interesting, guys? One starter pack is for one customer. Maybe the two starter pack can go to one customer, but one starter pack cannot go to the two customers. It is a single license. It's a server license. It does. You can allow Google, but you can block Google Chat. Even that. And it can block the ultra something also. Biggest problem, because everybody, what generally happens is, you block everything, but if they get into the other website through an Outlook and they click the hyperlink and they go, do that, but even it blocks. The technical is because we control the hash file, not the file name. So even if the intelligent user, they rename the file application and they try to go, we catch it through the hash file. It blocks that. So this association is just all about a profitable partnership, and you don't have to really come back to us saying that, you know, I'm working in this particular case and therefore you give me a special price. You don't come back to me because you decide what business that you want to make and what margins that you want to make. So you create a sense of ownership. The moment when you put one effort to sell a starter pack, you get about four benefits. And there are some new schemes which has been announced by our regional manager saying that about 18th pack, you could sponsor one of your employees to a foreign trip. So friends, I invite all of you to become a part of the K7 Army. More than that, it is a made in Indian company, made by Indian, which has been succeeded across the world. In Japanese market or in US market or in African market, it's been already been succeeded. So it is a made in Indian product, made by Indian and made for Indian, because we understand the Indian scenario, because my product even can run on a P4 machine with a Windows 95 or an XP. It doesn't say that, you know, you have to add RAM to run the particular thing. It can run on that, because basically on the manufacturing organizations or the education institution, they don't change the machines quite often. They have the old history machine, but still it can run perfectly well. So this is only going to be a journey of success with High Profit. I request all of you to support this brand. And it's not that we are a one-person army here, we have a huge army. I would like to call upon all the K7 people out on the stage here, please, quickly. So the differentiation here is, probably you would have seen any other competition with one person for the, across the country or the state, but here you would see an army of people out here for to support the Mumbai market. Yeah, we have the support people here from the local market, we have the pre-sales people here, so if they are, once you identify a particular case, my people would be there to help you to close a particular case. It's not that, you know, we sell the product, we run off the road. Because we want to approach the market a little different. Because this product we are trying to bring into the market by saying, we are trying to create the infrastructure now. Because our money is going to be made from the secure virtual desktop. So we are trying to acquire maximum number of customers, create the customer base, and to launch the new products. About 7 products to be launched this year. So this is my army here. Can
you? Good evening, everyone. My name is Sushant Jana. I have joined K7 as a regional sales manager. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Santosh Kolika. I have joined K7 as a business manager for the Harbour and Central. Good evening, myself Sushopalan. Yes, I handle
pre-sales
for West India. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Shrikant. Maybe you know me from Microsoft, like Microsoft. Yeah, I joined here for K7, but as a business manager. Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Vishal Pandey. I have joined here as a business manager for Western Solar Region.
Hi, myself Karan Dabuwala. I have joined K7 as a business manager for the Surat region.
I would like to say something about today's scheme. We have launched some scheme for today. The scheme would be, you know, if you are going to buy 3 number starter pack, then we will get 3 starter pack free. So we have a feedback. So please fill up the feedback form and return back to us. Thank you.
So let's give a round of applause to K7, please. All of us. Welcome K7 on as a gold sponsor to us, sir. Friends, as most of you would remember, I don't know, somebody may remember or not remember. Some few months back, one of our own member of ASSERT, Mr. Jayesh from Janitor Data Systems, had explained to us some concept of how some of us could get together at our own individual level and collaborate and to bring sort of one solution, one face to the marketplace. I'm very pleased and happy to announce that some of us in the room have taken that initiative to collaborate and to get one kind of a face to the customer. But I don't want to steal the thunder from him. So please welcome on stage one of our own members of ASSERT, Mr. Deepak Chadha, who will let us know what is he they have done, which I think all of us can learn and take from him. Thank you.
So I think the biggest challenges faced by retailers, system integrators, everybody here is, can I have some? 2, 3?
Yes.
So what are the challenges today?
Managing the high cost of retail outlets.
Great.
Yes?
One. So all of us have the same problem, okay? And just one simple thing is, I think we got to realize between ourselves that we aren't competition amongst us. There is backend, okay? So the competition is not between us, right? The competition is somewhere else in a different vertical, which probably we didn't strike the right note at the right time a couple of years back. Okay, so it took us a good 2 years just to get a set of people together who were facing similar set of problems, claims, backends, manpower issues. So one store owner handling all the issues, okay, doesn't work well. lot of issues because he doesn't have time, he doesn't have the bandwidth to address all those issues. So, you know, we've been really happy and proud that 11 of our fraternity friends have got together to form a company. It's up and running right now, absolutely as I speak. Okay. And the best part is that those 11 people, okay, were absolutely thick competition to each other some years back. Okay. We managed to have our own brand right now. Okay. The brand is called You and ID. Okay. We've got 26 operational stores up and running in Bombay right now. There is a central purchase. There is a person responsible for backends. So instead of 11 people doing the same thing, we have just one person taking care of it. And we've realized that we've got some 9 extra heads just to take care of growth, sales, marketing, and profitability, which I think is, you know, the need of the hour. Okay. So my purpose here is just to probably, you know, tell each one of us that I think it's high time now we get into a collaboration, okay, and individually, you know, there is nothing much we could do, right, because of, you know, resources being limited, time being limited, etc. Okay, so Assert has absolutely, you know, given us a right platform to get together, helped us, you know, overcome some difficulties, okay, in terms of, you know, addressing various issues, right? So, the benefits of this is purely that, you know, we have, you know, kind of achieved to have economies, scale, as well as skill in this, right? So, I think if retailers could probably get together, I think it's not much of a challenge that system integrators can't do it. So, you know, really request that time to think. The competition is not your guy sitting next door or somebody else. The competition is big. You have to get together in a big or a bigger way, and only then, you know, you could probably survive the entire game. Anybody for some questions? How this is possible?
No,
with a very open mind, that's
send,
it.
Send us all the prices na, so that we can sell more.
Yes, sure sir. Not only prices, we're going to have a uniform look and feel of the store. Okay, everything is just going to be very much, you know, inside.
What about
so,
the support?
Sorry?
What about the support?
Centralized.
Yes, absolutely. So the staff is going to be looking similar, talking similar languages. Okay. Sorry? All of them are directors, and you know, it's a, we've created a brand. So it doesn't matter today if a customer goes to a Chembur outlet or Ghatkopar or anywhere he wants to buy. It is absolutely one company, that's it. Everybody is welcome. If you want to make money, share profits, everybody is welcome. Oh yes, of course, because collectively, okay, the buying power has gone up, okay, the costs have come down, okay, that's where the pure margins are. Okay, I had a company called Cyborg, but I still have it, right, so that's one outlet, we have 3 outlets, right, but the cost for 3 outlets and, you know, managing, one person managing these, very difficult. So we have now close to 5 people taking care of the sales and marketing of each outlet, including mine. So I take care of, I have a different role, somebody else has a different role, etc. So like, it's becoming more easier.
I have 2 questions.
Yes.
Firstly, if a person wants to join you,
yes,
if you are a franchisee or if you take us into the board as a partner?
No, not as a director, because of course the company is formed. So maybe I think we can look at the franchisee model, but the cost for, let's say, the company giving it to a director's outlet and a franchisee outlet, everything is going to be the same. Everything. If I get it at 100 bucks, you're going to get it at 100 bucks as well. If I have probably a brand promotion running in one of my store, okay, it's going to be the same in each and every store.
Okay, so there would be a franchisee agreement and there will be a...
Yes,
Absolutely.
Apart from this, like, you know, if we have a 2-3 outlets,
yes,
we convert one into the franchising, yes, and run the our own company also, or then it will not be allowed to run the separate identity.
So it is very simple. First is that, okay, there is absolutely not going to be, there are zones to be defined where it, example, if you are in Ghatkopar West, okay, so we will see to it that, you know, there is nobody else in Ghatkopar West. The idea is for a partner to make money, okay, again, not come under Ghatkopar West and then 1 kilometer again, and you know, two franchisees or two stores fighting amongst each other, no. It's purely first come, first serve. So,
I can run one store under your name. And will you be allowed to run another store in my name?
Yes, absolutely. Well, the only thing is the store which you choose to run under this umbrella. Yeah. Okay. Somebody shouldn't be present there. That's the only thing. Somebody should not be present there. Then you guys will compete amongst each other. The whole purpose is
that.
Yes, sir, that's
okay.
Oh, yes, of course. See, here the beauty is that, you know, your brand is not going to die. Okay, your brand is absolutely not going to die. We all understand we put equal efforts into creating our own brand also. So we absolutely respect that. Absolutely. Yes. No, we just want to bill it on one company. Let him internally distribute in this other company. It doesn't matter. So automatically the volumes come here. That's okay. That's okay. Everybody is welcome. If you feel that we bought the product and we are giving you a competitive price, okay, whatever. Everybody, it's okay.
Absolutely.
Yes, of course, money. Yes.
Absolutely. What about the running costs of the store?
Already, these are, I mean, they, these guys are already running the show, everybody, including me, right? Okay, so whatever you sell is your profit. Don't think that the profits are mainly going to come by purchases, okay? The more you sell, the more you make money, because you're going to get it at a cheaper cost. Your cost would be coming down, okay?
You mean to say your indirect costs are all borne by the store owner?
In the stores, more or less are done up only, everybody. Jo chote mote hai,
we are talking of the trading profit. Only talking of the trading profit. Whatever I purchase or whatever I sell from you is the profit margin that I get.
No, I mean, it is not the monetary part only which we are looking at. It is also providing all sorts of expertise, sales, training, furniture, decor, okay, stationeries and, you know, dress codes, uniforms, everything is going to be standard. So if somebody comes at one of the existing outlet and a customer walks into your outlet, okay, he should not feel that he's gone into two different stores. That's the whole idea.
Probably one outlet requires 5 salespeople and the other outlet requires only 2 salespeople.
So that's your selling strength. You already have.
Who bears that cost?
Sorry?
Who bears that cost?
Who bears the cost?
So, see, all those things, okay, why don't we discuss it? We have a plan, which I'm sure,
we have.
So, anybody, I mean, can you get in touch with us.
One sec. Can you send to all the members, detail, fine-tuning, whatever the proposals are there, rules are there. So, then afterwards, we discuss, that's better.
We'll send you a profile.
Yes.
One thing I want to add here, you know, this concept what was there is they have started for the retailers. But there are a whole lot of system integrators here probably who must be having the same ideas. The idea is just that the fact that we are meeting every month, that there's a, you know, a formal, informal bonding taking place, that is very, very important for us to start our own. You know, if some of you have ideas that, okay, let us do something in networking, let us do something in pure box pushing in HP or any, could be any brand as such. The idea is just that we have, you know, they have started something, you know, who are individually fighting with each other, and now they have a, you know, suddenly a base of 26 stores all under one brand name. I think that is very, very commendable. You know, I think, you know, all of us are in our 40s, we all have our own egos and, you know, businesses, whatever. I think killing that is, I think, one of the biggest challenges which you must have had, you know.
there is absolutely, you know, the ego is gone, you know, absolutely gone. And we couldn't dream of having, you know, stores outside of Bombay. But today, I think we can proudly say we're present in Bombay, Pune, Nasik, Aurangabad and Satara. Okay, within like 5 days. 5 days, that's it. Okay.
Yeah, discussion. We have time, we have time.
I'll be with you. So if your strength is services, okay, and if you're in a certain geography, okay, I have a customer there, okay. I mean, you want to cater and you take whatever it is, those things can absolutely be, macros can be always talked about. Okay.
So services company
can be sales, service, pairs. It's all three S's.
Thank you, thank you. Give a round of applause to all these people who have joined and this. Anybody here who was there? I think we can probably, you know, we can request them probably later on to in one of the sessions in future to give us a, once things are more formalized within you all, to give us a more formal session on how they could do it. So we can also start thinking on basis if people who want to do it, you know. So, and he's anyway around, any more questions we can have. One request, K7 has given the feedback forms. Can I request everybody to please fill it and give it at the desk over here. We'll take a 15 to 20 minute break and soon after that, we will be having the Canon session. Canon products on display over there. A lot of exciting products. Can I request people to have a look at that at the Canon booth as well. Thank you. We'll take a break for 15 minutes. Consumer System Products Division in Canon. He's associated with Canon for more than 7 years, handling channel and system integrators for the Western region. Canon will basically are presenting today behind on the counter there the latest Wi-Fi range of inkjet all-in-ones, laser printers, and Wi-Fi range of laser all-in-ones. There are some special display products as well there. So request you all to go there at the end of the session today to have a look at the Canon products. So without further ado, let me get on stage Mr. Abhijoy Bakshi. Can I request you to give a round of applause for him, please? Thank you.
Mumbai team and our partners. Can I call upon my team, please, and partners? Yadvinder Vel, he takes care of Mumbai and Gujarat operation. Sandeep Rai takes care of system integration. Satish Gangure takes care of the marketing activity for West. Mr. Vishal Pandole and Manoj Tiwari takes care of Mumbai Market, Western Line and Road. Can I call upon Mr. Marlino Briganza? He is our technical head coming from. Let me call upon Mr. Rahul Zaveri and Yogendra Singh. And also Nilesh Javedi and Bhupendra Singh. They are the owners of Paxonics Technologies, taking care of our laser product division and Apex Enterprise takes care of our Indian product division. That's all. This is my Canon in Mumbai. So we all will be here. You can interact with each other. And now I hand over the mic to Yavinder to take you a session through what we are having, what we are offering today, and also Malino for the technical details of the same.
Here for entire version of Mumbai and Gujarat for CSP products. So our session is basically not focused much on sales, but to interact with you that what is beneficial for you is up from Canon side, how we can enhance your business profitability and working together. That is all the whole agenda is. So but first we will talk about what is Canon all about, what is the technology fronts. Second is product range and features, market analysis, and product management. So whenever any business partner comes to any business meet, he always has three questions in mind. The first thing is why? And why Canon? The first thing is always in mind is why Canon? And the second question comes in his mind is what benefits and value I'll get from this brand, which is I'm going to associate for lockdown. And the third is how it is better than the competition. So these are always the three questions in any businessman mind, that how I can get benefited from this brand. So I will try to give all the answers whatever I can give you better. Otherwise also before, after that also you can, you know, just coordinate with me for that if something is not answered. So as a Canon, if you see, Canon is almost 75 plus year old company. Currently $45 billion US dollar company globally. Head office in Japan. Total, if you talk about 2010, total employee strength is 1,77,000 total employee globally. And Fortune 500 company, we are ranked in among 35 top companies in Fortune 500. And if you talk about patents, Canon is the fourth biggest company having the patents. The first is Samsung, then Microsoft, Intel, and then Canon. So Canon having the biggest R&D infrastructure in terms of manufacturing. So whatever we sell, we manufacture it in-house. No outsourcing. Even if cartridge is also, that is also manufactured in-house. Nothing is given to outsource to manufacturer and then we are selling. So everything is quality. So quality promise is our logo. So this is our brand. We are present across global. You can see everywhere we have headquarters. India headquarters also shown there in Gurgaon. So this is the history, how we started up. 1934 we started up with a camera production and going towards we are manufacturing and creating differences. And in 2010 we also invented the printing presses, professional printing presses. So this is how our R&D structure is going forward throughout these 75 plus years of innovation. So this is all about technology fronts, which is Canon is, you know, breathing. This is our total product gamut. If we talk about Canon, Canon is a complete imaging and printing solution company. We have complete solution starting from a printer of 1100 rupees to a machine of 7 crore rupees. So entire complete printing solution and the imaging solution. Imaging is all your camera, starting from a small digital camera to a large lenses which go to NASA and everything. So this all complete range which Canon, which is all in-house manufacturing. So this is a complete gamut, DC, digital SLR projectors, IR cameras, consumable lenses, printing presses and all these things. So this is the brand name which is given to each category. If you talk about digital cameras, you will always talk about XS, power shots, video, digital movie cameras, photo DVs, SLRs, large photography cameras, you will call it EOS. So every product range is given a brand name. So our inkjet printer given a brand name of Pixma. All inkjet printer you will find Pixma. And in laser, you will always find LaserShot. So this is the brand name given to entire product range. So in the industry today, if you see, none of the company is growing in a pace. Almost every company is now struggling to get either the top line or the bottom line, right? Then also the growth is also not today any company is talking about that they will grow up to 20%, 21%. But if you see last 6 year graph, Canon is tremendously growing from 500 crores to 1850 crores in last 6 years. Last year also we submit a growth of 21% over last year, which was the highest growth in industry today. Entire industry was a stagnant mode or negative or either struggling for the bottom line. So we did hit in the bottom line, but top line we were very good. So we grew 21% in last year also.
and we had a clear vision to buy 1 billion by 2015. So what shows you this here is you can be associated with a company who also has a vision to grow. So any company who is growing, with that only the partner can grow, right? So that is our vision. The second question comes, why? How it is beneficial than the competition? So this question answer, we have 5 points which we say is our strength. The number is, one is innovation, technology and powerful products. On our product range, we can just vouch for anything, never failure will happen. We first test that any product coming into the industry, we test that product for at least 1 year in our in-house test, then only we come out that product. Any product you will say is a robust, and technology front, all advanced features you will find. The second thing is, again I told you, complete imaging and printing solution company Canon is. Third is low cost orientation. Now we have understood the Indian markets also. So we are now coming up more and more printers with low cost also. Then strong service network across India. We have around 28 towns or cities, you can say, where we have on-site support across India. We have 111 CCCs across India where we have locally present, and all network is being managed by Canon. It's not outsourced. So that is what assurance of service you will get. That means if you are saying that we will close the call by 24 hours or 4 hours, it will be closed on the system. And entire service network is on site. Either it is a printer of 1500 rupees or a machine of 7 lakh rupees. All machines are on site support. Then is the corporate philosophy, Kyosei. So Kyosei is living and working together for each other goods, common goods. So we are working that you should also earn money, we should also feel that we should earn money. So if our distributor will not earn money, that we are not happy, and we are not earning money, our distributor partner is not happy. So our philosophy is very clear, you should earn money, then only we will earn money. So we work in a common goal. So just few names, just few points I have, which awards which we have recognized in industry. CI Exim Award we get for the business excellence last year, and now it is continued also this year. We also have got this ISO 27001 and oblique 24001. Business Excellence Award. Then Reader Digest Gold Category Award, this we have got as the best company in India. Then we also become the 9th highest asked company in Asia. We had 9th position overall in top brands last 2 years. We have taken around 180 plus awards in last decades of 7 years. So this is a journey which is going on. Either we win some award in best camera, best SLR, best printing solution. So all these solutions are getting these 180 awards in India. And then the top 25 best employer in India. So we are currently at 16th position, where we are saying that Canon is the best employer, having the best employee and satisfaction level. So now we just talk about what the Canon is all about. Imaging and printing solution we talk about. That which are the subdivisions which are actually working, product division and subdivision. So categorically, if you say, we have 3 type of range. Number one is CSP, which we are here present, consumer system product, talking about only the printing solution, scanner and consumable part. So this is the CSP. Then first is image communication product, entire camera range, SLR, their selfie printer, photo printer. And third division is office imaging solution, which comprises of photocopiers, large format printers, wide format printers, which competition called is at plotters. Then we have production printing division, the large presses, which now 1 crore or 200 plus crores, these all presses are there. Then we have a subdivision which is actually catering to national retail chain. So NRC like Vijay Sales, Chroma, Big Bazaar and all that. We have their separate subdivision. Then we have institutional sales division, which is gifting and corporate selling, corporate buying. This is a separate division. Then we have Canon Image Care. This is a new concept which launched last 2 years, and we are very successful in that. So the success story of last 2 years in Canon is the retail and direct relationship with partners. The first success story we will talk about is our national retail chain direct tie. So first we were through distributors. So then we started up tying with the direct retail. We have a direct touch with the customer. So only one phase is with the customer. Then second phase comes is the Canon Image Care, Canon ke khud ke showroom. So currently we have launched 102 showrooms across India, and we are present in around 50 cities, 50 towns in India. So So that becomes a success story because we are just close to the customer. We are reaching the technology to the customer. So second success story. Third is now with the direct retail stores. So this is an opportunity where you can get aligned yourself. As in the evening, we were talking about the retail stores. The food industry is moving from, you know, channel distribution, channel partners to a retail business. So that is a big business and we are ready to invest in that. So in any of the setup, we are ready to work for the retail setup. Because we feel that Pixma and entry-level laser are actually home segment machines. So we are ready to invest. Any of the business opportunity for retail is there, we very much open. So these are some of the business opportunities where you can tie up. You can think of Canon, either in photocopiers, printers, wherever you feel. But there's a big business lying there. It's all about value, relationship, and long-term planning. So Canon is a brand where you can think long-term and just shake hands. So that is all from us. Because all SI partners are like that, working long-term, not short-term. So that is all. So now we talk about CSP. CSP has two product categories, inkjet product and laser product. Inkjet is comes with inkjet single function, AIO scanners and inkjet consumables. Laser comes with laser single function, multifunction, laser packs, toners and cartridges. So this entire laser product category is being driven in Mumbai, entire Mumbai is by Faxonics. So Faxonics is exclusive distributor for entire Mumbai, laser single function, multifunction and long range. And inkjet machines and scanners is being driven by Apex Enterprise. So any support in terms of that they can address. So this is our subdivisions in total in CSP. Now a little bit talk about where the opportunity is for in terms of laser machine, where the opportunity is for the SI partners who are system integrators, who are not actually selling one machine but a large number of customers. So currently if you see last year, almost every laser company has grown. If you talk about Canon, HP or any other company. Industry if you see is not growing in terms of single function and laser multifunction. Not very big leap. So how the opportunity can come to system integrator? So here we are showing that even the industry has grown, but the major point seen here is, if you see, the industry has, we are sitting in 2013, the entry-level laser contribution in the total business is 20% today. That means 2900, HP1020 will sell only 20% of the total business. Currently, all partners are focused much on 1020 and 2900 black. So that is one area which we are losing for somewhere else. Second is the 17% market size is for the mid and high segment. That means 20 ppm to 22 ppm, 24 ppm machines is 74%. Then is the 30% market size which is from 22% to 40%, which is the highest in the category today. And here is the opportunity lying. This is the industry, how industry potential is there currently, and color machine has 11%. If you go down by 2015, how the market scenario will be. By 2015, only 10% contribution will be from entry-level laser. So in spite of focusing and investing on entry-level, as you all are SI partners, system integrators, you can actually focus on laser mid and high-end and start pushing them. Try to find out your customer. Ask Canon how we can do. Come to us. Let us share the ideas. Let us bring some innovative ideas and let us push to the corporates. And this I am showing how we and current companies are working. 52% is entry level we are focusing, I am saying. So we are actually in a wrong position today. So we want actually the SIs and good partners for a long term relationship where we can actually bring out some great business. Because it's a big business and margin there is no issue. Minimum margin we assure to any, even to distributor also, we say we don't want to work you below 3% to 4% even in trading. And even our corporate partners, because SI is all about corporate business. So we feel that there should be healthy margin. So currently Canon has a complete range in terms of laser single function, multifunction and all product range. Only thing required is the handshake in terms of mid and high business. So opportunity is big. This is the opportunity for the system integrator in terms of laser business. So if anywhere you are stuck up in entry level machines, please try to leave that for retail. And seriously, leave that for retail. Let us focus on mid and high machines, above 20 ppm machines. So this is how last year growth has happened, year on year. If you see HP has grown by 51% total, Canon has grown by 22%. We are number 2 currently in India. Then the Samsung, Panasonic, Epson and all are contributing their share. This is a share of 5. total. So we are second biggest brand today in India in terms of laser and inkjet both. So the third opportunity is the consumable business. Even I am into the industry from last 15 years, so what I am looking that many of the partners are moving from machine business to consumable business. Many of the partners are trying much focus on pump business. Margin is high, corporate has to buy. We still feel that there is a fake or you can say refill, but still the market is 47% if you see. By 2015, the market will still be 53% of the total business. If there will be total revenue of 4,290 crores, so the 50% business will be from consumer business only. So big opportunity in consumer business. Mid and high end and cons. This is the biggest thing. So where you should focus. More rate contact with the corporates. When you will sell mid and high end machines, you will also sell the consumable for them. So that is a recurring business for you. So more you sell mid and high end, more you sell consumable also. So long term planning, margins. So that is how the system integration works. So this is the insight how the laser business can contribute and we can work together. Now is the inkjet single function and multifunction. I am thinking that since last 4-5 years, more of the home customer is also taking away the laser printer and laser single function and multifunction at home. Because they were taught that inkjet sook jati hai, ink sook jati hai, kam pay jate hain, theek hai, warranty theek nahi milti. So let us remove inkjet from home and let us take laser at home. So now again industry is shifting from laser to inkjet. So the only industry which is growing this year is only inkjet, single function and multifunction. It's growing by around 3-4%. The total magnitude of business is around 14 lakh machine in a year, total India. So big opportunity is also in inkjet, single function and multifunction. Don't lose this opportunity. Either even in an SI mode, you can also focus on consumable business. You can focus on the higher end machines. We'll just show you how we are placed globally and how we are placed nationally. So if you see total Asia market, this is a total Asia market. Canon is number one across Asia in inkjet single function multifunction category mix. Asia mein Canon is number one. Only India is the market. Only India is the market where we are number two. So Asia mein Canon is a 48% share and HP you can see is 26% share only. So only India is the market. See the India. India HP is 51% and Canon is today at 24%. So opportunities are because Canon is today clearly focused that we have to be number one in India also. So mention here the top 10 machines which are selling highest number. Canon has introduced new series called Ink Efficient E510. 700 rupees cartridge give you 800 pages in one cartridge. So that gives more print cost. Even if customer has a requirement of say 800 pages in a month, need not to buy a laser, buy a E500, E510 at home. Because 700 rupees he is getting 800 pages, so less than 1 rupee. Print, scan, copy, color also, he can use color at some time. So this is the project which we launched last year, Canon India Inkjet number 1. So we started 2012 by 14% market share and we closed 2012 by 22% market share. Q1 2013 we are at 24% market share and we have clear cut agenda that 2013 we will close by 25% market share and by 2015 we will be at 41% market share with number one with leadership in India also. So here is also the opportunity. So all the retailers, all the customers who are actually interacting with the media houses, printing houses, so there is an opportunity lying. So that is the third, fourth opportunity for you. Because Canon has planned to grow, that means if we have talked about 25% last year, we did it. So this year we are talking 25%, we already 24%. So we'll do it. So this is how we are placing our product as Pixma. We are placing not a machine, we are placing it as a solution. Competition is saying it is a print scan copy. We are saying it is not a print scan copy. It's a solution. It's the Pixma. What is Pixma? In spite of print scan copy, it will give all these six solutions. Full high definition movie printing, Creative Power Premium, duplex printing, on-site support, 2-year on-site warranty, print collage features, print albums at home. So these are solutions which we are providing with the machines. So we are not selling all in months, we are selling Pixma. So from my side, I could say we are not talking sales, we are talking business opportunities. So I have told you four business opportunities: system integration, laser multifunction, iron. Second is inkjet machines, laser cons and inkjet cons. So we are open, any association, you can come out to me, either my team member. So we are very much open for the opportunities, and either of the business session we can do, we can have it. From my side, I would just complete my session here. Now I will request Merlino to give you just little bit insight about the product range in laser single function and multifunction, and little bit about the USP of the product. What are the USP of the product which you can pitch in the industry? I will request Merlino to please. Thanks a lot.
My name is Merlino Braganza. I handle trainings and presales for a division called CSP for Canon India. I won't take much of your time today because Yadvinder has already tried covering the commercial aspects of the products what we sell. I'll just give you a brief out of what opportunities we have in terms of technology and in terms of understanding the customer when it comes to selling our high-end products. So, just to start with and just to add to what Mr. Yadvinder said, we have four main divisions in Canon which provides us revenue, which are revenue generating divisions for us. We have CSP, ICP, OIS and BPP. So I won't spend much of time on this slide. My team and Abhijoy's team actually represents a division called CSP, which is consumer systems product. Now, as the name suggests, consumer systems products, we sell all products which are of use for a consumer when it comes to imaging and printing. So, from the imaging part, we sell scanners, and from the printing part, we sell laser printers and inkjet printers. We also have a division called ICP, which is Image Communication Division, which sells cameras, and it has a specialized printer, which is known as Selfie, which works on a very different technology, which is dye sublimation. We have a office division, which is Office Imaging Solutions, which has its expertise in selling A3 copiers and document scanners. So any product which is used for imaging and printing in an office or in a corporate scenario is sold by OIS, which is Office Imaging Solutions. And then we have the production printing department, which actually sells the large format machine. So if the customer needs to print on a media format which is bigger than A3, so A2, A0, A1 and bigger sizes, then we have a specialized division for that, which sells PPP and which caters to those products. So we have an entire gamut of products today. We have an entire range of products to support the customer to our end user, and we would require your help in getting the reach to the end customer. So you can also keep on asking questions to me during the session. If you have any doubts, any queries, I'll be very happy to answer them. So this is one slide which actually talks about the printers. We in 2013 have launched somewhere around 25 new machines. So lot many people think that Canon in 2013 is the same Canon which was in 2006 or 2007. Actually, when we talk about Canon in 2006-2007, Canon had very limited range of products. We had just 3 or 4 lasers, 3 or 4 Pixma or our inkjet series and just 1 or 2 scanners. But today, can someone tell me how many products do we market in India, the CSP division? A rough figure, how many products do we market in India? Sorry? 50, okay. Any other answer? 100? Oh, that was a vague answer. any other answer? 50, 100, anything between that? 75, okay. So, sir was actually very near. We actually market 51 different products in India. So you just missed by one. So we market 51 different products in India, which actually comprise of inkjets, lasers and scanners. So that is the gamut which we have. So I'll show you the gamut, all the products what we market in India. But just to give you a brief out, let me spend a couple of minutes on talking about how things sell in India. So you as system integrators are our elite partners who would actually help us selling our products then at places like the government segments, PSUs and big corporates. So when you talk about Indian mentality, or when you talk about, let's talk about global mentality first. Global mentality actually goes on brand, speed, quality, technology. But in our country, the first question which is asked whenever a person purchases a printer is, what's the print cost? Am I right? What's the acquisition cost? What's the cartridge cost? So in our country, the mentality actually focuses on cost. If I add to it, just have a look. Indian market actually goes on kitna deti hai. Whereas global market actually goes on technology. So even today we have shifted, we have actually tried to read the minds of the customer, and we have shifted our trend of selling from what we used to do in 2006-2007 to our latest trends today, where we have very economic products at a price range of somewhere around 4000 rupees and very economical cartridges which give you a print cost of somewhere around 40 paisa to 50 paisa per page. And this is what the PSUs, the corporate segment and the enterprising segment of today, of the emerging India needs today. So depending, reading the customer's mindset, reading the frame of business, what is happening in India since last 2 or 3 years, we have actually launched a very big range of products. So we have actually launched 23 new products in 2013. 23 new products. And the specialty of the products is, the acquisition cost is very less, the products are in a range. If you talk about lasers, and we have actually displayed a couple of multifunctions at the back, the cost of these multifunctions is in a price range of somewhere around 15 to 20,000, which used to be somewhere around 25 to 30,000 couple of years back. And if you talk about the inkjet series, we have solutions. So as Mr. Yadvinder was telling, that today Canon doesn't believe in selling a printing device. We actually believe in selling a solution. You all might have seen the ad which HP does, right? The ad for 449 rupees, the cartridge ad, the digital ad where it is targeting the education segment, right? So we never target a customer at 449 rupees. Why? Because we are not into that gamut. We don't play into those scenarios. We target our customers in selling solutions. So today we have displayed the devices. You can have a hands-on on those devices which are displayed at the back, which actually are solutions. They are not printers, they are solutions. You can print, you can use the devices as Wi-Fi devices, you can use these devices as solution providing devices, you can use these devices as card making devices, collage making devices, fine art making devices and things like that. At a very low and very substantial cost. The devices which we have displayed at the back, the PIXMA devices, these would cost at a maximum of somewhere around 10,000 to 12,000 rupees. But what we are giving is a solution to the customer. So that is our entire motto of getting our team over here and displaying the devices, that we are not actually in India selling printers. No, we are not selling printers. We are selling a solution in totality to the customer. And that is the help what we want from you people. We don't want you to go and talk about Canon as a product. We want your help to go to the ATEP fraternity and talk about Canon as a solution providing company. Right? So, taking forward, this is a simple slide which actually talks about what all products we have. So, when you talk about the printing devices, if a customer needs a printing device for his home segment, we have the inkjets. For the office segments, we have lasers. For the production, for the commercial segment, we have high-end devices which would give you studio-like quality. So today we also have devices which can scan your 35mm rolls which used to come in the older roll cameras, digitize them and print those snaps. So entire technology, all the three things bundled in one device. This is a slide which talks about the service reach. So in totality, we have somewhere around 132 authorized service centers throughout India, which are catering to tier 1, tier 2 and tier 3 cities. And apart from that, our reach is to somewhere around 2,800 cities pan India, wherein we are providing full services. One differentiating factor about Canon as selling solutions in India is, we provide a 2-year on-site support on majority of our products, which competition doesn't provide. That is one of the major differentiating factors of Canon. Because if you talk about revenue, every penny counts. To an Indian customer, every penny counts. Now suppose I'm selling a printer which is costing 5,000 rupees. I'm selling it with a 2 years warranty. My competition sells a similar product at 4,500, but it sells it at a 1 year warranty price. If he needs to purchase, if the customer needs to purchase an additional warranty of 1 year, again he has to spend 800 rupees extra, which actually increases the acquisition cost of the machine. So my machines by default gives the customer a free template of mine for 2 years. That's the most beneficial thing, one of the most beneficial things which the customer gets after purchasing Canon, peace of mind. So our tagline also says delighting you always. Why delighting you always? Why do we have that tagline delighting you always? Because delighting comes from satisfaction. And when you are selling a product, the most important thing which comes through satisfaction or for satisfaction is the warranty aspect, the after sales support. So just to put it in a nutshell, we have got a full range of after sales support. We have tier 1, tier 2 and tier 3 cities and very wide coverage. So earlier, again let me talk about 7 years back or 8 years back, Canon didn't have a very good service support. We used to be present in some of the metro cities only. Metros of those times, metros of 2005 and 2006. But today, not only the metros, we are also present in tier 1 and tier 2 cities. So that gives a peace of mind to the customer whenever he's purchasing a product from us. This is the reach. Okay. Now, this is the gamut of our single function devices, wherein we would like you to position all our devices to different customers. So today, as you can see, we have devices starting at an 18 ppm speed and going up to 40 ppm speed. So we have entry, which is 10 to 20 ppm. We have mid segment, which is 20 to 30 ppm. And we also have some devices in the higher segment, which is 40 ppm and 40 ppm plus. So many of the system integrators throughout the country, even today, they have a very vague perception about Canon, that Canon is the same company which used to be 4 years back or 5 years back. 5-watt devices, 18 ppm speed, poor service support. So I'm not talking about you people here, I'm talking about some of the people who still have this mindset. But today let me just correct and let me just emphasize on this, that Canon is a company which has a wide gamut of products. Customer comes in with a budget issue, we have a product which deals with budget. Customer comes in for a product wherein he looks for options like duplex, networking, Wi-Fi, we have products. And very recently, just last week, we have launched some multifunction lasers which have full support for AirPrint, iPad printing, Android printing and Google printing, Google Cloud printing. So competition used to talk about Google Cloud Print or Android Print or iPad Print only through inkjets. Canon has a wide portfolio in inkjets as well as in lasers. So what I do is I'll use an iPad, I'll print a photo and I'll just show it to you right away after this slide. So this is the portfolio what we have for mono single function lasers, a very wide gamut of products. In the color portfolio again, we have very wide gamut of products wherein we start at 14 ppm. We had a product of 8 ppm, but now slowly and slowly we are moving from 8 to 14 and we have products up to 35 ppm. So very wide portfolio, and especially for SI partners like you, it is very important for you to understand that the entire market today is shifting from mono to color. So earlier we used to have black and white newspapers, right? We used to have black and white newspapers. Today every newspaper comes in color format. Why? The cost of production goes up the moment you start using colors. But then why do newspaper agencies and people like magazine producers, why do they move up to color? Why more of color? Because color is more appealing, color is more demanding, color is more innovative. And that is the reason why today even the end user is moving from mono to color. And this is one very important thing. This is one very important phase which is coming up in India for the customer moving from mono to color. This is one reason why we are having products in multiple colors. We have kept a model at the back, which is MG3170, which comes with inbuilt Wi-Fi and duplex. We are marketing this model in India in three colors: black, white and red. So black and white for people who would like to use the product normally, and red for attraction. So we have actually seen that the sales of model of red color was 10 times on days like Diwali, Valentine's Day, and because it was actually used for gifting purposes, right? So color plays a very important part, and that is one thing on what Canon is emphasizing today. Another very important thing is mono multifunction. So today we are leaders actually in the mono multifunction category. There are people in the market, our competitors, who would actually play on pricing, who would actually cut deals on pricing. But Canon is one company which would never compromise on pricing. The reason is because we understand and deliver quality. So today we have a very wide range of products, starting right from 18 ppm product to 35-40 ppm product. So my colleagues at the back would not be able to see what is written on the slide, but just for you, we have brochures of all our products kept at the back. After the session, you can just have a look at the products as well as you can take the brochures collectively. Color multifunction, again, we have launched lot many products which would give you direct Wi-Fi connectivity and direct features like AirPrint and Google Print. So, Vishal, can you just get that iPad, please, if you don't mind? We also do market fax in India, but generally, again, fax is a marketing and selling fax is a very important thing for you or for your fraternity, because fax actually goes only in the government segment and in the commercial usage space. So we have two models dedicatedly for fax. And we are selling these two models successfully in India since last 3 years. Coming towards the end of the presentation, the most important product category, or I should say one of the most important product category, the inkjets. Inkjets are today the most important things or the most important solutions what we are providing to the customer. And inkjet, you just name what you want, you just mark what you want, and we'll give it to you. You want a printer, we'll give you a printer. You want a print copy scan, we'll give you a print copy scan. You want a print copy scan fax, we'll give you that. You want a duplex machine, we'll give you that. You want Wi-Fi, we'll give you that. You want Android support, we'll give you that. You want iPad support, we'll give you that. You want direct printing support, we'll give you that. You want a machine which can print your Google documents which are stored on the cloud, we'll give you that. You want a machine to print your Google Docs without the use of PC. Directly you can see the document on the printer's control panel, you can pull it and you can print it, we'll give you a solution. So you name the solution and we deliver the solution. So Pixma is today the highlighting thing which is happening in Canon. We have somewhere around 20 products in this category, and we have actually broken this category into two parts. We have photo printers and we have high-end photo printers. So if some of you would require to position a solution which is equivalent to, which would actually give you a quality equivalent to a studio, then we have the Pro series. So we have Pro 1, Pro 10 and Pro 100, which has been launched in 2013. These three products have been launched in 2013 at a very high, so the price is obviously high, but the quality that these products deliver is beautiful. It's unmatched. Apart from this, we also have 4 scanners. Now the best thing about our scanners is, Light 110, our entry-level scanner, actually enjoys a dynasty market share. So we actually have a 62% market share of this scanner in the country. And we are holding this market share since last 5 to 6 years. And all our scanners are Mac, Windows and Linux compatible. So that's again a beauty which none of our competitors would ever offer. So any questions? Anything you'd like to ask? So we have a product wherein you can digitize. We have a solution wherein you can digitize. So if you have a 35 mm roll or a 120 mm roll, you can scan that entire roll, or you can scan slides of that roll. You can digitize the slides.
and then you can either print those digitized slides or else you can store them. Right? So we have a product for
that. Handhelds may be an Android-based phone or may be an Android-based app. So what I'm going to do is, I haven't installed any software, nothing, in this Apple iPad. The only thing is, we have a router over here. We have connected this iPad to the router and we have a Pixma MG5470, which is one of our mid-segment products with Wi-Fi. So we have, I have connected my iPad with the router and I have connected my Pixma with the router. Now what I just do is, I go to, if you cannot see, people sitting in the back, if they cannot see this, I am really sorry, but I'll explain it. I go to settings, I go to Wi-Fi, okay, I've turned Wi-Fi on and there is a router by the name of Yarn Home. Okay, so this is actually Mr. Yagender's router which he has got. So the name of the router is Yarn Home. So this iPad is connected to the router. Now what I do is, I open any picture. So I'm sorry, this iPad also contains some personal pictures. So okay, let's take this picture. I just click on to-do, there's an option for print, I'll click on this, automatically my iPad would start searching for printers. Can you see this? Automatically. And if there is a printer in range, it displays it over here. Right? Like over here it has displayed Canon MG5400 series. Now the only thing which I need to do is select this. And click on print. So this also gives me a message that MG5400 is low on ink. So I can replace the ink tanks or else I just click on OK. And I think it has started printing over. Right? It has started printing. So it's printing, right?
Yeah.
So can I cancel it from here? So it's going to take time. Alright, so you can cancel it from there.
I show you the print now.
No, that's okay. You just cancel it because I'll show the scan. You need to cancel the print. So we have remote printing as well as we have remote scanning. So what you can do is after the session or after, I'm sorry, after the closure of this session, you can just walk up to our the demo units which are at the back. My colleagues will just click a photograph through this iPad of yours and will instantly print it from our printer and we can view it. Okay, so anyways, so this was remote printing without any software. So,
are you demonstrating a feature of iPad or a printer?
This is the feature of printers.
This doesn't work with other brand of printers?
This feature
is a feature of iPad, right?
The AirPrint. So this happens because the iPad has a standard called AirPrint. If you have AirPrint in the iPad, there is no need of downloading or installing any software for printing.
That's what I'm saying. It's a feature of iPad. It's a feature of iPad.
Yeah.
That's what I'm saying. It's a feature of iPad.
Understand one thing, sir. AirPrint is a feature of iPad. Right? But the printing feature, the remote connectivity is a feature of the print. Now what I'll do is, just to add on to what you have, I'll just take you to a software which I have downloaded, which is freely available for Android users as well as for iPhone users. Canon Easy Photo Print. Now through Canon Easy Photo Print, I can do the same thing and I can also scan. So pull scanning. So just imagine you have, you are there in the living room, your printer is kept in some other room and you need to do a remote scan. Can you just keep some document on the flatbed? Yeah, this would do. Okay. So this is the document which we had scanned earlier. What it's going to do is, it's going to remove this document from the memory and then it's going to reload the document which is there. I click on scan and scan. Scanning. Okay, print cancel kar diya tha. So this is a feature which is not of the iPad. This is a feature of EPP, the Easy Photoprint software, which is freely available for download. So I think you will have to restart the printer.
Yeah, I'm doing that.
So till the time the printer gets restarted, do you have any questions? Anything to ask about this? So I'll just print it, I'll scan and show you both the things. It'll just take a minute.
At what range does the wireless printed scan start?
So our wireless printed scan starts at what, 5,500?
5,100 for the end customer.
5,100
for the end customer. Anti-level 3170 comes in 3 colors also. Red, white and black. Body color is 3 colors.
Okay, Chalu. Started.
Yeah,
sorry. Okay, so I click on scan. So we will select the printer first, set as default, and then scan. Coming up with a machine with CCD scanner in September. domain knowledge for CCD scanning, we would be having dedicated scanners. So we'll be having dedicated scanners. That has been discussed. We can work out for something for you, sir. If you give us a brief, we can just. And if my commercial manager can just come
in. We can check the Singapore and we can then come back.
We can do it.
We can check out. We can check the top.
So, any other question? Anything else in tech classes, sir? I'll just have a question.
You said in Asia you are number one, but in India you are number two.
Yeah. Okay.
Now, if you want to really become one,
yeah.
Number one, you can have some USP on Canon product range, which might hamper with the price range. But all other competition is offering starter toners or starter cartridges. Except 2900, all even Canon has a starter. Why don't you come up with full toner that will become a USP and then.
Yes.
We can easily sell,
yeah.
And pitch against the competition.
I even missed this.
That's
point.
The only
all
USP of
my machines. All Pisma machines come with full cartridge.
Now the number two.
All Pisma.
When you
have all machines.
Just
it's not that only 2900P comes with a full toner. Our entire range of mono single
full
function comes
full
with a full
toner. But multifunction comes with a starter.
Multifunction comes with starter. Entry level comes.
This is something which is. Needs to be improved. Why can't it be a full tone?
We'll take a feedback. We'll take it as a feedback, sir. We'll surely try to implement it in near future. But currently, only our single function products come with full tone, mono single function, which even the competition is not offering.
There
so we
one,
have an upper hand.
There
it's
one,
not really low.
There is one product Canon is running since quite a long time, that is mobile printer.
IP100.
Have you ever bothered to look into its pricing as compared to the competition in last 4 years?
Yes, sir. Yeah.
It's way beyond 21,000, 22,000 for us, and competition is selling at
17,000,
18,000.
No, now it's
revised.
Already this is available. This
way
only 70,000.
That doesn't ship with the battery. Then you have to buy a separate battery pack or made of thing for. Because that is optional.
So
Canon
that also sometimes if back to back cases, there are substitute cases even for two machines also. We used to get a special price. Something is required. Otherwise, for that normal consumer, it is that price.
In consumer segment, what kind of margin you expect the SI to earn?
In higher end modules?
Entry level modules, consumer segment.
4%?
Sir, what is 4%?
What is
delivery cost?
Sir, what is
0%?
So when you talk about entry level, that is all about numbers. When you talk about entry level.
Absolutely, but if you think about a customer who is using one printer, two printer, or one printer, we have 100 customers.
So no.
A single cartridge delivery even doesn't come to
you. I am not saying that you sell to retail customer at 4% margin. I am not saying that.
That's
our,
what the condition is today, sir.
Our philosophy in Inkjet, I am saying. Inkjet is clearly MOP, DTP. MOP to DTP transfer price is 18%. So whatever we sell to you, if you sell at Chroma, if you sell at direct store or CIS, it will sell with 18% margins. We are able to give you. You sell at MOP. Whatever price TARC is selling, whatever price Chroma is selling, we will give you same lending.
Today, if you look at the pricing structure of the consumables, really we are not able to make out any penny on gun consumables as compared to the competition. This is one. Number two is any protection towards competition in LFRs for SIs.
No, if you say even inkjet cons also, I say, because consumable customer only buy at MRP. I tell you. So minimum margin in entry level cartridge also we have kept 10%. Right, Upendraji? Not less than 10%. Not at all. Nothing less than 10%. Because you sell at MRP. We don't recommend it that you sell at below MRP to the customer. Later we are saying if you are trading that, then we don't say you that we say 10%.
So LFR competition.
So only one point which is very crucial for us in Pisma is cloud printing. So what is cloud printing? You have Google user password, you have documents on Google account, you have presentation on Google account, you are sitting in Singapore, you want to fire a printer at your home. So your printer is compatible for the Google Cloud.
the net, even you are sitting somewhere else, you can fire a print from your mobile or an iPad and print will come at home. So all machines starting from 6,800 rupees in Pisma and above are Google Cloud compatible. So machines above 4270, 4270, 5577 and all Wi-Fi are compatible with Google Cloud. So this is a very good feature for WordPress. LaserPay with Wi-Fi 4720 is a machine and 4570 DW and all of our machines are Wi-Fi.
And so very soon we are also launching Wi-Fi
signal. Wi-Fi signal. 4700 is 4700 rupees. 4700 rupees with Pixma with Logitech headset fully worth 1200 rupees. Any customer, even you buy 3000 rupees AIO or you buy 20,000 rupees AIO, customer will get Logitech headset fully. So, one more point I just have for the partners who are actually into retail or customer connected. We have a demo policy. We have a demo policy. Either you buy E510 or any Wi-Fi printer 5 machines in 2 months, May and June combined, you will get one machine for demo at 50% cost. So demo policy, any machine you buy, 5 machines, any color. So this is a demo policy from Canon. Rest Rahulji has a lot of things for you. Questions about the last one?
Good evening everyone. Actually, thanks to Assert, they have given us a great opportunity to say something about our company, our products. So thanks a lot. We are very thankful to Assert guys. So we have learned some scheme for Assert members. So we'll be providing 5 inches antivirus pack to everyone of Assert members for 1 year. Okay, as per the business concern, if you are getting good business, then we'll think about the lifetime for these products. Thank you.
Within 1 week, they will send it to our offices. So,
yeah, it will be free of cost.
On behalf of Canon, I would take this opportunity to say I got 200%. So and I heard you are saying 4% also. So that makes a difference. Thank you.
Before we move ahead, there's one announcement for the next Assert Tech Day. We have a very exciting concept or event. We're planning a CIO event. Well, thanks to the CIO choice people, Mr. Anup Mathur, we'll be getting probably 2 or 3 CIOs over here who will be interacting with the SIs to understand what their needs are, what do they look for when they talk to SIs, what are their expectations, and what should we expect out of them. So request you that next month, please be there, it's going to be very, very exciting. It's already on 21st June, so please mark those dates in your calendars. And let us go on to our final speaker for the day, evolved speaker for the day. He is Mr. Rajesh Dhawan, a chartered accountant from Dhawan R. Company, practicing since 1996. They are specially trained for audits, statutory, tax, MVAT, investigation, tax planning, financial planning, and registration process under various direct and indirect department, company formation, and health startups. So without much ado, can I please request Mr. Dhawan to come up? Let's give a round of applause to Mr. Dhawan.
The World International Finance Corporation Publication and doing business in India to perhaps pass in this year. Structure of business in India, basically it is proprietary, partnership, LLP, and corporate bodies. Partnership, LLP, and corporate bodies are governed by different statutes and rules. As per each type of structure has its own benefit and pitfalls. Benefits and pitfalls. As per latest KYC law, in financial institution and government department, preferred structure of business is partnership firm, LLP, and corporate body. Tax structure of India. अभी हर जगह पे आपको tax लगता जाएगा. Value of goods जैसे custom duty plus excise, VAT, compare LLP question mark, maybe next government. On profit, income or bad tax लगता जाएगा. Business establishment services, service tax or professional tax लगता जाएगा. एक्चुअली मेरे पास वो था ना ब्रेकअप हर एक्ट के अंदर जैसे सर्विस टैक्स में 80% पर एनम है. अभी आप दोनों को थ्री मार्केट्स पे काम कर रहे हैं जहाँ पे हमारा रेंज 15 से मुश्किल से 18 का प्रॉफिट होगा. वहाँ पे अगर आप एक साल डिले करते हैं मतलब नॉर्मल जो दिखाते हैं पेपर यूनियन पर ऐसे बहुत ज़्यादा मार्जिन है शायद जो पेपर में दिखा रहे हैं. तो अगर आप एक साल हर कोई भी कॉन्फ्रेंस में लेट होते हैं तो आप इंटरेस्ट रेट देखिए सर्विस टैक्स में 18% उसमें वो स्लैब दिए हुए हैं टर्न ओवर 60 लाख के नीचे तो 15% पर एनम 60 लाख के ऊपर तो 18%. वैसे ही वैट में 15% पर एनम इनकम टैक्स एक्ट में तो बहुत बड़ी चीज है हर जगह पे. कंट्री टीडीएस अगर आपने रिटर्न फाइल की तो 200 रुपीज पर डे पेनल्टी. प्रोफेशन टैक्स में 15%. तो आपका हिसाब लगा कि आप एक साल में कहाँ कहाँ पैसे भेजे होते हैं तो जो पूरा मार्जिन है आपका पेपर वाला मार्जिन है एक्चुअली पेपर वाला मार्जिन साफ हो जाएगा. लेबर लॉस कॉस्ट में है शॉप में एस्टेब्लिशमेंट मसा बाद में पीएफ पीएसआईसी और ये प्रॉफिट टैक्स बताई. और आजकल वैट वाले लोग अभी क्या कर रहे हैं सब तो नोटिस भेज रहे हैं जो लोगों ने रिटर्न वैट ऑडिट रिपोर्ट भरी हुई है 2008-09 से चालू हो गए हैं कि आपका अगर 60-70 लाख का टर्नओवर है तो आपका प्रॉफिट टैक्स तो है ही नहीं क्योंकि ऑडिटर ने क्या किया 704 के अंदर नील और नॉट एप्लीकेबल फाइल किया होगा पंचिंग किया होगा. वो बोल रहे कि आपने प्रॉफिट टैक्स भरा तो प्रूफ दिखाइए नहीं भरा तो आप भरिए क्योंकि आप इतना बड़ा टर्नओवर कर रहे हो तो आपका एम्प्लॉय नहीं हो ऐसा हो नहीं सकता. वो सबको अभी आगे चालू हो रहे हैं रिसेंटली लास्ट वीक से चालू हुए. और बहुत सारे ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो है लोग जो वो मैं वॉकई नहीं कर सकता उसमें इसमें है नहीं वो मसाला नहीं इसमें जिस है वो आया नहीं मेरा एलबीटी वाला सारा वो आया नहीं इसके साथ रिलेटेड था जैसे व्हाट वी वर डिस्कसिंग MSMED जैसे रजिस्ट्रेशन है इफ यू आर सप्लाइंग टू ए लिस्टेड कंपनी ये जो बहुत एंटरप्रेनर्स लोगों ने रजिस्टर नहीं किया है या किया है तो उन्होंने इन्फॉर्म नहीं किया बिकॉज अभी सर AGM खत्म हो जाएगी जो लिस्टेड कंपनीज हैं. और अगर आप इफ यू हैव सप्लाइड गुड्स टू देम एंड इफ यू हैव नॉट इन्फॉर्म देम रिगार्डिंग के वी आर रजिस्टर्ड एज MSMED तो इफ दे डिले इन पेमेंट टू यू यू कैन राइट टू द ऑडिटर रजिस्टर सेंड वन लेटर टू रजिस्टर ऑफिस एंड जो बहुत लोगों को पता ही नहीं है बिकॉज दे हैव नॉट रजिस्टर्ड तो सिंपल फॉर्मेट है इफ यू सर्च ऑल्सो इन गूगल कि हाउ टू रजिस्टर MSMED साकी नाका दैट इज ऑफिस बट यू हैव टू इन्फॉर्म द पर्सन टू हुम यू सप्लाइड द गुड्स कि वी आर रजिस्टर्ड अंडर MSMED सो the statutory auditor of that company has to write in notes to accounts, or he has to pass reference in CARO, the tax audit, VAT audit, statutory audit report, कि इतना लोगों का पैसा नहीं दिया गया है टाइम पे. If you want, I will email you the forms of the connection letters. What important that government can say revenue generation, because they are generating more revenue in TDS and service tax without doing any using any machinery. So the cost of collecting money by the department or by the government under TDS, service tax and other indirect tax are lower than in direct tax. But the direct tax implications are more penal provisions are in income tax actually. If you see, if you don't pay advance tax, three slabs they have given September, December, March for non-corporate, corporate they have given June, September, December and March slab wise. If you have to estimate your income and pay as per the slabs, even if at the end of last quarter you are losing, but you have to pay advance tax because it starts prior to that. तो अगर आप देखेंगे थ्री सेक्शंस विच आर विच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल वन सेक्शन टू 24A 24B इफ यू हैव नॉट पेड एनी एडवांस टैक्स द इंटरेस्ट इज स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल दिस फाइनेंशियल ईयर फ्रॉम द लास्ट ईयर सो इफ यू हैव नॉट प्लान योर थिंग्स और यू हैव नॉट पेड एडवांस टैक्स और टीडीएस इज नॉट सफिशियंट टू कवर द इनकम देन द इंटरेस्ट हैज स्टार्टेड 1% फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल एंड फॉर डिफरमेंट they have 1% per quarter wise. तो इसमें सबसे ज़्यादा failure to deduct tax 1%, delay in payment of tax 1.5% per month आपको बता रहा हूँ income tax का है basically. क्योंकि इसमें ज़्यादा tax automatic है because it is all now mapped according to the database which they have as per AIR and other information. Default इन फर्निशिंग रिटर्न 234A 1% पर मंथ जब तक आप रिटर्न नहीं भरते हैं बीसी आपको बता दें रिसीवेबल सिर्फ 0.5 दे रहा है गवर्नमेंट
राइट है
0.5 लास्ट वाला अभी 1% का कंसीलमेंट कंसीलमेंट ऑफ इनकम जो सबसे ज्यादा होता है बिकॉज हम लोग खर्चा बुक करते हैं किताबों में भी नहीं लेके आता है केस में अभी वो लोग कंप्यूटर एडेड सिलेक्टेड स्टूडेंट ही है दे रन विद 16 टू 20 पैरामीटर्स मतलब दे हैव मेड अ सॉफ्टवेयर विद दे आर वर्किंग इन टैंडम विद IRS कनाडा एंड दे हैव क्रिएटेड अ सॉफ्टवेयर विच दे हैव इनपुटेड 20 पैरामीटर्स एंड दे रन दैट पैरामीटर्स टू सिलेक्ट द पैन नंबर with the database what they have collected from the various authorities. Now if suppose 1% they want to take the cases in scrutiny and after running first running it is doesn't come then they increase the parameter and that's why the scrutiny aap notice mein niche dekhenge likha hoga this your case is selected under cash CASS it is computer aided selected scrutiny. So now no chartered accountant can say ki aapka case scrutiny mein aaya ki nahi aaya और यू हैव टू बी प्रोएक्टिव इवन इफ ही सेज यू हैव टू प्रोएक्टिव और एक इम्पोर्टेंट बात थी बहुत सारे लोगों ने अपने अकाउंट्स के अंदर जो नॉर्मल सेविंग अकाउंट या म्यूचुअल फंड या शेयर्स
राजेश गुप्ता into manufacturing of plastics in Dhabani. I am a chartered accountant by profession. जैसा कि आपने सबने बोला कि chartered accountant का profession को नहीं इसलिए मैं profession में नहीं गया practice में नहीं गया तो भाई आपको another side of the profession इधर वो profession नड़ता है उसके other side पे जाने इसलिए इस chartered में own business the right is that the अभी government के compliances काफी ज्यादा बढ़ गए हैं There are various compliances.
वो काउंटाइज टाइम पे करना ही बेटर है, अदरवाइज ये रियल वो फॉर यू तो ये नॉर्मल बिजनेस। और उसके बाद ऐसा हो जाता है कि हम बिजनेस पे ध्यान दें कि उस कंपेंस नहीं किया उसके उसको सल्टाने में ध्यान रखें छोटे लोगों पे ज्यादा अप्लाई होती है क्योंकि हमारे पास एक कैपिटल लिमिटेशन के कारण हम बहुत ज्यादा प्रोफेशनल्स को एम्प्लॉय नहीं कर पाते, हम ज्यादा अपने पास एम्प्लॉयज नहीं रख पाते कि हर छोटी छोटी चीज को ध्यान दे रहे। तो बड़े ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में तो बैटरी ऑफ टीम होती है कि वो सब करने के लिए हर डिपार्टमेंट के लिए अलग अलग आदमी होता है। तो एक्चुअली अपने लिए बहुत बेटर है कि हम एक अपने टाइम टेबल है जैसे भी है कंप्लाइंस में बना है दैट वुड बी बेटर। थैंक यू।
सॉरी फ्रेंड्स एक्चुअली मैं वरुण भाई को मान लेता हूं कैसे आ गया इधर आज, लेकिन मैं इसमें मेरा जो मटेरियल जमा किया था वो कॉपी नहीं हुआ मे बी फॉर प्री ओपन सेशन फॉर क्वेश्चन आंसर ज्यादा इंटरेक्टिव होगा बिकॉज द मोर द प्रॉब्लम फेस बाय यू आर जेन्युइन ग्राउंड लेवल रियलिटी और थ्योरी में कुछ अलग होता है ग्राउंड लेवल पे कुछ अलग होता है तो दैट वुड बी बेटर आई थिंक। तो because it is in system so he can't help you much, sab kuch system mein ja raha hai aur aap log isse apply kar rahe sab integrated solution jo hai ye aap kaise pakdiye aapka employee kaam nahi kar raha to kaise pakdiye aapka attendance ho raha hai ki usko barabar pakdiye usko excel mein export hoga pdf mein export hoga aapke table pe aayega to department zyada use kar raha hai seedha एलबीटी मैंने वही पहले बताया ना 24% पर मंथ पर एनम इंटरेस्ट रेट चलता और उसके लिए सिर्फ 10 लाख तक वालों के लिए एक सिर्फ एक विंडो है सेविंग ग्रेस कि आप 10 लाख तक अगर टर्नओवर करते हो तो एक्स अमाउंट कमोडिटीज की भी भरती है यू डोंट हैव टू मेंटेन एनी रिकॉर्ड्स मगर नॉट आज 10 लाख का ट्रांजैक्शन कुछ नहीं लेगा तो हर आदमी उसके अंदर जाने वाला है और वो कैलकुलेशन इतना मतलब एक प्रोफेशनल को भी समझने के लिए आपको चाहिए तो मैं फॉर्म भी भेज दूंगा जो इन्होंने लागू किया है उसका पहले कितना इंपोर्ट हुआ आपका स्टेट में फिर आपने लोकल से कितना किया माइनस वो सब करके बाद में आपको एलपीटी भरना है वो बहुत कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है मतलब जो टेबल है एनुअल रिटर्न एंड सिक्स मंथ की रिटर्न वो था कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है इफ यू फेल हाँ देन द अभी तक तो क्या था कि मिनिस्टर फाइनेंस इन्वॉल्व थी और स्टेट मिनिस्ट्री इन्वॉल्व थी टैक्सेस के अंदर अब ये लोकल अथॉरिटी की आ जाएगी जो नहीं उसमें क्या है कि जो पुणे में हो गया पूरा उसका ऐसा था कि इफ यू आर वैट रजिस्टर्ड या डीम टू बी एलपीटी रजिस्टर्ड उसका वो लोग लेटर देंगे आपको वैट वाले के साथ लिंक करेंगे वो लोग
रिपोर्ट करता है अपना डेप्रिसिएशन के लिए या कुछ भी के लिए वो डेप्रिसिएशन नहीं क्लेम कर पाएगा अगर उसका बाइंग 5 लाख के ऊपर है और उसने एलबीटी नहीं भरा हुआ है या तो उसने एलबीटी पेड वाले डीलर से नहीं खरीदा हुआ तो 5 लाख का विंडो है जो अभी पहले 3 लाख का था और अभी नए नेगोशिएशन में 5 लाख तक का किया
है
पुणे में नहीं नहीं वो कंपनसेशन में आप क्या बोल रहे हैं कि लमसम भर दो 10 लाख पे बट 5 लाख तक आपको कुछ भी भरना नहीं 5 लाख का सडन जो खत्म किया है करीब 8 साल का एक बार सो आई व्हाट यू से व्हाट द अमाउंट इट विल बी पे ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट करके जबकि वहां पे सिर्फ 1% ना वो भी एलबीटी बनने के बाद 3.5% हो गया 300 टाइम्स बढ़ चुका है
मेरे पहले तो किसान के सर्विस टैक्स का है आई बाय चांस आई हैड अ गट फीलिंग इन जेल फेयर को दी को दिया तो मैंने बोला सर्विसेज रजिस्टर्ड है वो क्या सर्विसेज बंद करो आई थिंक एमनेस्टी आई दैट फीलिंग था कि बहुत पहले आई थी 1999 में तो उनका जो डिफरेंस हो रहा था पेमेंट का 5-6 साल का कम्स टू 30 लाख उसके अंदर 12 से 15 लाख रुपये इंटरेस्ट था तो अभी आप देखो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट तो मैंने बोला भैया आपके 15 लाख तो बच गए तो म्यूजिक कितने दे दो आप समझे तो आप बोले चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट तो अब तक पैसे भी नहीं लिए और उसके 15 लाख बचा दिए तो चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट अगर आप प्रोएक्टिव होकर आपके चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट डील करते हैं तो आई थिंक ये सब इश्यूज जो हमारे माइंड में है ना माइंड ब्लॉक्स हैं या उसके साथ हमारा ट्रांसपेरेंसी नहीं है वो खत्म हो जाएगी आप यू ट्राई टू लव हिम यार देन ही विल शो यू द वे आउट ही विल शो यू द वे आउट
You want to announce something? You want to
Sir Rahul Javed from Apex wanted to announce something. I think some free gifts coming, hopefully. No.